Hi students, how are you all? I hope you are all fine and safe. Had your tea in the morning? Okay, good. What are the varieties of tea you have known? Black tea, tea with milk. Most probably these two types of tea we have at homes. And why I am talking about tea? Because we have a lesson, a nice cup of tea in the second unit of our textbook. Shall we go into the lesson? A nice cup of tea. This prose piece is written by George Orwell. His pen name is George Orwell. Let's see his original name. Eric Otter Blair. This is his original name. He was born on 25th June 1903. And his life ended on 21st January 1950. He is well known by his pen name George Orwell. Have you studied any other his works? Animal Farm is the famous work of George Orwell. He is not only the famous writer, he is a famous essayist, critic and a journalist. He is one of the best writers of Britain. See the varieties of tea you have seen in the tea shop. See the pictures, they are all very good to see. First one is herbal tea, iced tea. Have you ever tasted iced tea? No, I too have not yet tasted. Lemon tea, most probably we all have tasted it. Green tea, these two we have tasted. Black tea, yes. And tea with milk. This is also the most variety of tea we have taken. Ginger tea. These two also we have taken. About the lesson. A nice cup of tea is an essay by the English author George Orwell. This essay was first published in the London Evening Standard. It is a discussion on the craft of making a cup of tea. We can wonder that, is it a lesson about preparing tea? Yes. Let's see what are all the things the author has given in the lesson. We may not know all these things. In this lesson, the author gives 11 rules for tea preparation. The 11 rules are considered to be golden by the author. The first and foremost point is, it should be Indian or Ceylonese tea. You should have in your mind that the author is speaking about tea leaves and not about tea dust. In our homes, we are using tea dust. You can see in the label, it is given tea dust. Okay, a nice cup of tea. This is a phrase which refers to the Indian tea by the author. The China tea you can take, but if you take the China tea, it won't give any eagerness. Then, second point, tea should be made in small quantities, that is in a teapot. If you make tea in a large quantity, it won't taste good. For example, army tea. In army, there are more people. If you want to make for more people, it won't taste good. Army tea is made in a cauldron. Cauldron means a big pot used for boiling. Army tea tastes grease and whitewash. One more point is, the teapot should be made of china or earthenware. Then only the original taste of tea will be tasted. If the teapot is made of silver or Britannia, the taste will be inferior. This is the second point. See the first point. Tea should be Indian or Ceylonese tea. Second point is, tea should be made in small quantities. Have you understood clearly? Then come to the third point. The teapot should be warmed beforehand, not in the kitchen alone. Okay? You should stand in the kitchen and you should warm beforehand. The fourth point is, tea should be strong. The author insists this point. The author insists that one strong tea is equal to 20 weak ones. The true tea lovers like only the strong tea. True tea lovers increases each year and the quality is important, not the quantity. Okay, then comes the fifth point. Tea should be poured straight into the pot. There should not be any strainer or muslin bags. And the sixth one is, water should boil at the moment of pouring tea. We should not heat again and again the water. It should be boiled fresh and we should make the tea. The seventh point is, after making tea, we should stir it or shake the pot well. And after that, we should allow the leaves to settle down. The eighth point is, one should drink out of a good breakfast cup, that is the cylindrical type of cup. Cylindrical type of cup holds more tea. One reason is that. The second reason is, if you use flat or shallow cup, tea becomes colder before we finish it off. The ninth point is, one should pour the cream off the milk before using it for tea. That is, we should remove the cream of the milk before using it for tea. If we use the cream, it will give the sickly taste. The tenth point is, one should pour the tea into the cup first. That is, we should not add milk first. This is the most controversial point, and the author insists on his own point, that is, tea should be poured first. The last but not least point is, tea should be drunk in the Russian style. What is Russian style? That is, tea should be drunk without sugar. You can wonder, I am not a diabetic patient to drink without sugar. But the author insists that if the tea is drunk without sugar, then only it will give the original taste. If we add sugar, it will give the taste of sugar. You need not add sweetness to the tea. If you want to taste the original tea, you should not add sugar. More than that, if you want to add sweetness to the tea, you can have the sugar in the hot water and you can drink. So, the author again and again insists that if you taste the real taste of tea without sugar, you need not ask for any sweetness. So, this is the last point. Have you understood all the points, my dear students? Now, we can see the meaning of some hard words. Curious, interesting, controversial, arguable and disputable. Controversial means difference of opinion. If difference of opinion comes, there will come argument. Then, virtues. Virtues means admirable qualities or great qualities. Despised, hated, stimulation, excitement, optimistic, positive and hopeful. Cauldron. Where did you hear the word cauldron? In the army. Cauldron means a big pot used for boiling. Rationing. You all know about ration shop because we all have in our locality. What is a ration shop? The things are given to all in an equal ratio. What is the meaning of rationing then? Restricting the consumption of a scarce commodity during war. Dangling, hanging freely, suspended. Spout, the pipe-like opening in a teapot through which tea is poured out. That is the kettle. Liable, responsible. Mysterious, incomprehensible. What is the meaning of incomprehensible? Impossible to understand. Etiquette, socially accepted behavior. If a behavior is accepted by everyone, it is called etiquette. See how beautiful the picture is. Tea plantation. Have you ever visited the tea plantation areas? Which are the areas you have seen? Yes, Manjolai, Ooty, Kodaikanal and Munnar in Kerala. What you have seen there? Have you visited tea factory? If you have the chance to visit tea factory, go and see the processing. See, some people are plucking the tea leaves. You should remember that only the tender leaves are plucked, not all the parts. See the single plant. Now, have you understood the lesson? Now I am going to give you some questions. You have to answer and give it to me in the next class. Okay, take down the questions. First one is, mention the countries in which tea is a part of civilization. Mention the countries in which tea is a part of civilization. Second one is, according to the author, what is the phrase a nice cup of tea refers to? According to the author, what is the phrase a nice cup of tea refers to? Have you all taken? Third question is, what should be poured into the cup first, tea or milk? What should be poured into the cup first, tea or milk? Fourth one is, what is the second golden rule in the preparation of tea? Fourth one is, what is the second golden rule in the preparation of tea? The last question is, what do you like to have in the morning, tea or coffee? Give your answer with the valid reason. What do you like to have in the morning, tea or coffee? Give your answer with the valid reason. I hope you have all understood the lesson, and I hope you are going to prepare a nice cup of tea hereafter. Now, shall we go to the questions? Take down the questions and answers. First question is, does the author like drinking tea with sugar? Does the author like drinking tea with sugar? Give your reasons. The answer is no. The author doesn't like drinking tea with sugar. Why? Because sugar destroys the flavor of tea. No, the author doesn't like drinking tea with sugar because sugar destroys the flavor of tea. Shall we go to the next question? Why does the author refer to himself being in a minority? Why does the author refer to himself being in a minority? The answer is, the author refers to himself as being in a minority because he drank tea without sugar. The author refers to himself as being in a minority because he drank tea without sugar. Have you all taken? Shall we go to the next question? What are the author's views on China tea? What are the author's views on China tea? The answer is, China tea has virtues. China tea has virtues and it is not despised nowadays. And it is not despised nowadays. It is economical. It is economical and one can drink it without milk. And one can drink it without milk. The last point is, but there is not much stimulation in it. But there is not much stimulation in it. What is stimulation? Eagerness. Once again, I am telling you the question. What are the author's views on China tea? First point is, China tea has virtues and it is not despised nowadays. Second point, it is economical and one can drink it without milk. Third point is, but there is not much stimulation in it. Next question, how does adding sugar affect the taste of tea? How does adding sugar affect the taste of tea? Answer is, by adding sugar to tea, we destroy the flavor of tea. By adding sugar to tea, we destroy the flavor of tea. Next point, when sugar is added, one no longer tastes the tea, but drinks sugar dissolved in plain hot water. Shall we go to the next question? Elucidate the author's ideas about teapots. For this question, we have 5 points. Take down the first point. Tea should be made in a teapot. Second point is, tea out of urn is useless. Third point, tea made in a cauldron tastes grease and whitewash. Fourth point, the teapot should be made of china or earthenware. It should not be made of silver or Britannia. The last point is the same thing. Silver or Britannia ware teapots produce inferior tea. Once again, I am repeating the same question. Elucidate the author's ideas about teapots. First one is, tea should be made in a teapot. Second one, tea out of urn is useless. Third one, tea made in a cauldron tastes grease and whitewash. Fourth one, the teapot should be made of china or earthenware. Fifth one, silver or Britannia ware teapots produce inferior tea. Have you all taken down? Then I am going to give you another set of questions. For those questions, you have to find out the answer. Small task for you all. I hope you have all understood the lesson very clearly. So, based on your understanding of the text, you have to complete the chart. I'll give you the chart with the clues. You have to choose the correct answer. Tea should be made in dash in a teapot. You first take down the questions and after that I will give you the clues. Tea should be made in dash in a teapot. Second one, the teapot should be made of dash. Third point, the pot should be dash beforehand. The fourth point is, the pot should not have dash. Fifth point, while pouring water, the teapot should be dash. Next point, the tea leaves should be dash. Next point, after making tea, it should be dash.
dash, or the pot should be dash, or the pot should be dash. Next one, the milk for the tea should be dash. The milk for the tea should be dash. The last one is, the author does not like to dash to tea. The author does not like to dash to tea. Now take down the clues. First one is, add sugar. While I am telling the words, you write with commas. Add sugar, shaken, milk, infused properly, strainers, without cream, taken to the kettle, small quantities, china or earthenware, stirred, warmed. Check whether you have written correctly. Add sugar, comma, shaken, comma, milk, comma, infused properly, comma, strainers, comma, without cream, comma, taken to the kettle, comma, small quantities, comma, china or earthenware, comma, stirred, comma, warmed. You have to choose the correct answer and fill it in the blanks. We have find out the answers for the synonym. Next, we are going to find out the answers for antonyms. What is antonym? Words which gives opposite meaning. Words which give opposite meaning. Shall we go to the textual exercises now? Okay. Then take page number 39 in your textbook. What is given there? Find out the synonym of the underlined words. What is a synonym? Words which have similar in meaning. Synonym means similar meaning or related meaning. Okay, shall we go to the exercises? Now you are going to find out the answers for the synonyms. You can check it with your textbooks. First one is, but because the best manner of making it is the subject of violent disputes. The underlined word disputes. You have to find out the answer for the underlined words. Option A, agreements. B, applauses. C, conflicts. D, discussions. You have to find out the answer for underlined word disputes. Once again, I tell you the options: agreements, applauses, conflicts, discussions. The answer for disputes is option C, conflicts. Second one, tea is one of the mainstays of civilization in the country. Civilization, you have to find out the answer for this underlined word civilization. Option A, a society in an advanced state of social development. Option B, a society that has slow progress. Option C, a society that has no progress. Option D, a society in an average state of social development. The answer is option A, a society in an advanced state of social development. Third question, that they only drink it in order to be warmed and stimulated. That they only drink it in order to be warmed and stimulated. Find out the answer for stimulated. Option A, motivated, B discouraged, C passive, D admired. The answer is motivated. Option A. Fourth question. Under the spout to catch the stray leaves. Under the spout to catch the stray leaves. You have to find out the answer for the word stray. I'll tell you the options. A. Fresh. B. Loose. C. Gathered. D. Harmful. A. Fresh. B. Loose. C. Gathered. D. Harmful. The answer is option B. Loose. Fifth question. One is liable to put in too much milk. One is liable to put in too much milk. Liable. The question is liable. The options are A. Likely. B. Certain. C. Eager. D. Responsible. A. Likely. B. Certain. C. Eager. D. Responsible. The answer is option D. Responsible. I have given the answer for those five synonyms, and I am going to give you another five words. For those words, you have to find out the answers. First one is curious. Take the words. First one is curious. Second one, virtues. Second one, virtues. Third one, economical. Third word, economical. Fourth one, infuses. Fourth one, infuses. Fifth one, sickly. Fifth one, sickly. Like synonyms, we are going to discuss about antonym. Now take your textbooks. See, five questions are given for antonyms. For those questions, I will give you the answers. And for the next five, you have to find out the answer. Antonyms, first question. Which are not to be despised? The word despised is the question. You have to find out the answer. Option A, hated. B, liked. C, respected. D, defeated. Option A, hated. B, liked. C, respected. D, defeated. The answer is option B, liked. Second question. One does not feel wise, braver, or more optimistic. The question is optimistic. Option A, opportunistic. B, cheerful. C, realistic. D, pessimistic. Option A, opportunistic. B, cheerful. C, realistic. D, pessimistic. The answer is option D, pessimistic. Third question is, not the flat, shallow type. Not the flat, shallow type. Shallow is the question word. Options are A, narrow. B, wide. C, deep. D, direct. Option A, narrow. B, wide. C, deep. D, direct. Answer is option C, deep. Fourth question. Predicting the arrival of visitors. Predicting the arrival of visitors. The question word is arrival. Option A, journey. B, departure. C, migration. D, perusal. A, journey. B, departure. C, migration. the perusal. The answer is the perusal. Fifth question, but they are sufficient to show how subtilized the whole business has become. But they are sufficient to show how subtilized the whole business has become. The question word is sufficient. Option A, enough. B, suffocative. C, inadequate. D, submissive. Option A, enough. B, suffocative. C, inadequate. D, submissive. The answer is option C, inadequate. Here, take down your question words. First one is controversial. First one is controversial. Second one, tasteless. Second one, tasteless. Third one, inferior. Third one, inferior. Fourth one, sickly. Fourth one, sickly. Fifth one, ration. Fifth one, ration. You find out the answers for all these questions. I hope you have all thoroughly understood the lesson, and hereafter you are going to prepare a nice cup of tea. I am going to prepare a nice cup of tea. Thank you. Have a nice day.
நிகழ்ச்சியை பற்றிய தங்களின் மேலான கருத்துக்களை கீழ்கண்ட முகவரிக்கு கடிதம் மூலமாகவோ மின்னஞ்சல் மூலமாகவோ குறுஞ்செய்தி மூலமாகவோ தெரியப்படுத்தலாம். அனுப்ப வேண்டிய முகவரி சிறப்பு அலுவலர் கல்வி தொலைக்காட்சி 8 தளம் அண்ணா நூற்றாண்டு நூலகம் காந்தி மண்டப சாலை கோட்டூர்புரம் சென்னை 685 தொலைபேசி எண் 7824001500